that's cool. No worries, no worries. Where are you? I should do it.
There we go. Good to go. What's going on, brother?
How are you, brother? Brother.
Good, man. How you been?
I'm all right. Clean cut now.
Yeah, I see that. That's like dolphin smooth, baby. Look at that.
Looking like a kid. Thank you, dude. COVID.
No problem. What's going on? We got Z handling everything for the Vipers in the house.
But
what's been up with you, man? How's the pandemic been treating you? I know you're a DJ, so you've been out of work as far as doing appearances and clubs and stuff.
I've been in and out, to be honest with you, with appearances just because of the whole social distancing. Can you hear me? Is everything cool?
Yeah, we're good.
It's because sometimes I cover my hand here, and sometimes people say you can't hear me. But anyways, yeah, I've been in and out of appearances, obviously. I still have been going to the radio station, though, on daily, like weekday daily. And I go in Saturday morning just to kind of kick off the mix show at 12 o'clock noon on Saturdays. Y'all should go listen to it tomorrow. It's going to be going off crazy for the Memorial Day weekend. But Sundays I'm usually off, and I'm sure you've seen some of my lives. I've been posting some of them, but I'll go live on Facebook, and I'll try to stream it to the other platforms as well. But that's pretty much all I could have done right now, is just keep it all interactive online. Social media is probably one of the best tools that we've all learned about 2020 for sure. So
definitely. But when you're doing those lives, is it a lot more for you when it comes to getting those reps in performance wise and stuff?
Man, I want to say that all in all, it's a good circle, not just for me, but just for like anybody that's involved, whether you're watching, dancing, or even just having it in the background. You know, like, it helps me help you either get through it, and it helps me get better while getting through it. You know what I'm saying? It's all a big circle, full circle ahead. But if anything, is it for me? All in all, sort of, because I just love doing this. Like, this is all I do. It's all I've ever done. So
yeah,
it has affected me in a sense. Mm-hmm. Because I'm so used to being where the public's at, you know what I'm saying? So doing it behind closed doors was the trick that I had to face with. So, but I learned, every DJ learned, OBS is a motherfucker. So did you learn that shit too?
I've been learning. Everybody's getting creative during this whole pandemic thing, man. I usually do my interviews on camera at events like at Comic Cons and stuff. So I've been doing a lot of Skype interviews, and what's going on, Rich? Rich Trev has joined. What's going on, Rich? I've been doing a lot of interviews, like doing this, like on Skype, and you're actually my first Instagram Live interview. The reason why I did want to interview you, not only because we've always meant to get together since we met at the Vipers games,
right?
But tomorrow, is it tomorrow? Tomorrow all the clubs open up. Is that correct? And tonight, You have what's, I guess, your last pandemic performance.
Pandemic night?
Yeah, your last
pandemic. I want to say it is, but I'm actually going, I don't want to say it's my last pandemic performance, because I am reaching out to, I mean, I am reaching out to other people on these social platforms that do live in other full force pandemic cities that are in need of entertainment. Oh, you know what I'm saying? So like I have found other peeps like that are in Florida or that are actually based in that are now in California. That place right now is wicked strict. California is wicked strict.
Yeah, I think LA County shut down for another 3 months over there.
Yeah, wicked strict. West Las Vegas, wicked strict. Like there's just some even my friends and some of them are like really good entertainers there in Vegas. They can't go anywhere, you know what I mean? They're so used to performing there in one of the biggest cities of entertainment, and it's a shocker to everybody, you know what I mean? But yeah.
So tonight, outside here is gonna open up tomorrow, right?
Well today. Today London is open. All the bars are open. Well, most of them.
Downtown. So how do you think that's gonna feel for you? Do you think when you do those lives, you're keeping yourself on your toes and, you know, it's saying for your performances. But now do you feel like your senses has forgotten the feeling of a crowd? You know, the vibrations under your feet and you know, the sound of crowd cheering or dancing.
I feel what you're saying. It was almost like the same feeling I got when I did my first couple of lives online.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of like the same, vice versa, you know what I mean? Like, if you've never done something online, well, your feet are going to be so wet that they might turn into raisins faster than you think. But I also did notice a lot of people that were online were being interactful enough to, I guess, encourage me to understand that they just kind of enjoy entertainment, regardless whether it's in person or online. Like, if they're there online with you, they're gonna enjoy what they're watching. Now, for physical performances like tonight at London's, how it's gonna be very limited, I think that's gonna be the catch. Because usually in scenes like that, there's so many people, and sometimes people depend on other people.
Mm-hmm.
Not just the DJ, because the DJ could be great as fuck, but everybody could still be sitting down off the wall or to the side, you know. But there has to be somebody in there. Somebody has to get the party going. And yes, the DJ is a big involvement too, but I've learned as an MC, and I don't know if you've gone to any of the venues that I performed at. I used to perform downtown, but now that I perform at London's, I do it there. And what I do normally, what I've noticed, like at the beginning of the night, no one moves, but I'll be that guy. I'll be that guy. I don't care if you're looking at me. I don't care if I look stupid. I'll just move. But with the new rules regarding this whole phase two rendezvous, there's no dancing. There's no real interaction. You have to keep it real limited. So it's going to be more like a piano bar. But
I just realized.
Yeah.
Like if you're doing the 6 foot thing, it's kind of like in middle school when you get the slow dance and you're afraid to hold her, so you just kind of like trying to dance like this, but
but even in middle school, man, shit, even in elementary, my first dance was in elementary, and I was a third grader. Yeah, I was a third.
You young little rascal, you! I remember middle school. I remember those dances. Those were, I thought I knew what I was doing, and I didn't.
I was listening. I don't even remember what I was listening to. I think third grade, fourth grade, that was still Usher. I was phasing into Usher and Ludacris. I was getting into that shit. You know what I'm saying? But
yeah, let's continue that conversation. What kind of music did you listen to, and what can you go back to the time that you realized, yeah, I want to do this for a living?
Man. I remember sneaking on my mom's computer. She had songs of DJ Laws. She had this one song. It's called Mami El Negro. Pum, 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 pum. Una canción, no, 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 no. It was just, it sounded just like that, like the beginning. Pum, 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 pum. Esa canción es about una abuelito or something like that. I don't remember the full words, but it was probably one of my favorite DJ Laws songs. And it's all about Mami drum and bass, you know, hip hop and all that shit. He actually goes live on Instagram too, and fucking kills it. But he like legitimately, he'll go live and then he'll immediately delete his live set. So it's like, if you saw it, you saw it. Yeah. But he was pretty much my clicker. Him and Timberland. Timberland. I don't know what it was about Timberland's beats, but his beats made me like made me jig.
He has a lot of like it sounds like jungle drums as far as pattern goes. And man, his and you know what? He always keeps the good beats for himself. Whenever he does like an album for himself, those beats are insane. But it's not downplaying all the beats that he's done. Have you been watching the Versus series on Instagram?
I was able to tune into one. I was really entertained by what's his face? The other guy. He was doing the live radio show. Tory Lanez. Tory Lanez was doing. You're going live from Instagram radio. I don't know what it was. He was going hard like that.
I've been catching him on YouTube. I saw.
I think they charged him or something. They cut him off.
What's that?
They put him in Instagram jail or something like that. Tory Lanez.
Oh, did they?
Good guy.
Yeah. No, good guy. Great guy. No, but I watched the Lil Jon and T-Pain one. That was dope. And then there was a Manny Fresh with Scott Storch. But Scott Storch, like, he was using stuff that he co-produced, like, with Dre and
he has rights to use.
And I'm like, come on. Like, he used Cry Me a River. He used Breaking Neck by Busta Rhymes. I'm like, I associate those beats with those other producers.
I feel that. But I feel like if you make the melody, I don't know. I think that's what it is, because he created the melody. He created the actual, like he created Cry Me a River.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, he created that. Like, that was his. So it's like, fuck, what do you do? I don't know.
There was one with Neo and Jonte Austin, and they were battling with songs that they wrote for other artists too. That I get, yeah. True. You know, you kind of like, when you're playing songs, it's not just the song. You're doing mixing yourself. You're messing with the equalizers, and you're kind of making a new sound with that song. Is that mostly on the spot, or is there stuff that you practice at home that you say to yourself, I should use that next time I'm out there?
I should honestly practice more at home. And I'm not trying to say that just to say that, but I should practice more at home. Except when I do get home, I knock the fuck out. Go to bed. And when I wake up a couple hours later, I have to be somewhere in about an hour or two. Like right now, I woke up not too long ago, and I downloaded some songs on my phone charge. And I have to be at London's for a Zoom meeting. But it's going to be like a private party on Zoom, because they all can't make it to London's. Someone there at London's is having a little shindig with their six people, but they're also putting me on Zoom with their phone. So I'm going to be paying. They're actually going to pay me to play at London's through their Zoom on their phone. You know what I mean? It's so crazy.
That's dope.
It's just another way, I guess. You know what I mean?
Another way to make some money and entertain some people.
But yeah, I don't know.
You work at I got people here. Like, I got my cousin joining. He's in Pittsburgh right now.
Shout out to Pittsburgh. I almost forgot. I didn't even answer your fucking question. I got so lost. But
it's all good.
As far as your
but you do work at Wild 104. And that's our local hip-hop radio station. How long have you been working there?
6 years now, actually. I've been doing a lot. For my first year and a half, though, I was doing a lot of the I guess you could say, technical stuff, learning what was around our radio, learning all of our equipment, learning the sites, you know, just in case. Honestly, like, I was the bottom of the bottom of the bottom of the bottom, right? And at that point, like, I made it a point to use the time that I had at that bottom to at least visit and learn every little avenue of the radio, whether it was sales, whether it was a technician, whether it was the engineer, whether it was the fucking the jock, whether it was the janitor. Sometimes you got to go in there and you got to clean something, you know what I mean? So I'll go do that too. So I did that. But for the first year and a half, it was kind of like that. And then Johnny fucking Shout out to that man right there. He said, hey, can you read? I was like, yeah. can you read? I was like, yeah. I was like, he's like, read me this.
I know we're in the valley, but damn, bro.
I was like, read me this. I was like, so I read it. But it's because I think I had encouraged him to hear me out once in. To the Art Institute in Austin. So after that, I came down here and then, of course, found my route. It wasn't automatic. It wasn't college and then radio. It was like college. And then it was like, fuck, what do I do for 2 months? Then I found Kirby, sold some vacuums, and sold a few. Okay. I'm not going to lie. Almost went to
Disney. Sold a few. My man knows vacuum.
Bro, I sold vacuums. And after I sold vacuums, I sold cars. And after I sold cars, I said, all right, maybe I don't belong. I can do it, but maybe I don't belong in it. You know, I need to go back to what I really wanted to do. And then this opportunity came. I did a DJ competition. I didn't win, by the way. Like, I didn't win. I just kept the faith, and I kept emailing, and I kept bugging. And eventually I found my way in to an interview. You know what I'm saying? So 5 years later, here I am. On DNC. Okay,
now you do the morning shows with Johnny O, who's like an institution when it comes to radio out here in the Rio Grande Valley. You have any funny Johnny O stories, any quirks about him that nobody knows about?
Johnny O likes to eat everything cold. Everything.
What? Everything. Really?
Cold. He'll bring snacks in the morning. Like the other day, he'll bring snacks. He doesn't necessarily bring me something. He just brings snacks in the bag. He's like, hey, I have some snacks in the bag. You want some? You know what I mean? Like, whether it's a taco or steak, or maybe he bought pizzas from the night before and he brought them in a Ziploc. You know what I mean? And I'll even ask. He's like, you want to go heat it up? I'll go heat it up. He's like, nah, I'm cool. And he just rips into it cold, and it's still cold from the fridge. Like, it's like, what?
Now, I want to say like 10 years ago, I had an online radio show, and I used to call every morning, like, bugging Johnny O, like, asking him questions. I'd show up to the station, and I'd have, like, tacos for them, him and Ashley, when it used to be Ashley in the morning with him.
Oh, I remember Ashley.
And shout out to Ashley. Hope she's doing well. Yeah, and he used to let me in, and then he used to let me in the studio, and we used to hang out. And I remember he was so cool about just trying to teach me something. Now I've moved on to doing interviews and stuff. So now, what do you see for yourself in the near future, or do you have a long term?
That's a big question, but I don't see me stopping music. That's for damn sure. I still see me doing music as an old man. Eventually, I think I'm gonna learn to do. Shout out to Dante Cabello, Brazil, watching. What up, brother?
Brazil, we in Brazil right now.
Yes, sir. We are in Brazil right now.
What's going on, Dante? Thank you for watching.
Rosie Rodriguez, Pierre Nova. What up, Faith Princess? Hey.
Yeah, everybody's here.
That's awesome.
I got Aldo, my cameraman, my boy. I got Layla.
Dante Carmelo. Amanda. You gotta do an interview with him, man. He's cool. He's cool. Dante's cool, man. He does
not. Dante, make sure you follow me. Let's link up.
Argentina, man. When I went to Uruguay.
Yo, Argentina got crazy food, bro.
Yes. So this is crazy. I met Dante in Montevideo. That is in Uruguay.
Okay.
With the Vipers, we went. Me and the Vipers coach. We actually went to the Snake Charmers, coach. Remember her?
Julie.
No, not Julie.
No.
Bruh.
The Snake Charmers coach.
Yes.
Did I meet that person?
Yes. You've never met the Snake Charmers coach? I don't want to burn out her name for privacy purposes. So
no. I mean, It's all good. It's all good. You oh, went cool. there with her.
Yeah, so we went there with her because we got invited by ESPN Brazil 2 and SP2 Brazil and all of them to go run games. So she was appointed to be like a team coordinator on the floor, and mm-hmm. I was appointed to be house sound or whatever. Anyways, Dante was the fucking MC. Dante was the MC of that motherfucker, yeah. And Dante was the coolest cat of them all. I'm not gonna lie. Dante was just real chill, real laid back. Didn't think this guy was the MC when I first met him. And then all of a sudden, I just see his cool, goofy looking ass walking on down there. And this guy is just, he's just great. He's Latin MC. He does his thing and he rocked it over there. He does his fitness over there. He does fitness in Argentina, but he does a bunch of Instagram live fitnesses. So
that's Dante. Oh, dope. Everybody follow Dante Cabello. Dante
Cabello, shout out to that man. Free plug for Dante.
Make sure you guys look him up and see what kind of fitness stuff you can get from him. Shout out to Dante. So he'll talk about your relationship with the Vipers.
Dude, I hope we go back.
Oh yeah.
I heard that professional sports are starting after May 30th.
Yeah, I saw that.
No spectators.
I don't know how the season goes with the G League. I just hooked up with them this season.
I don't know. I think they might leave off where they left off. The Vipers didn't have too many games left, from what I knew. Oh. I think they only had like three games left in the month of February.
Yeah, so.
They were gonna. The last games were in March, I believe. So, I didn't know how they were gonna do the playoffs or the G League in total. But I know that they are gonna have professional sports soon with no spectators, and hopefully they don't fucking start charging to watch it on TV. You know what I'm saying? So, that's just food for thought. But other than that, bro,
I miss going to those games. I miss the energy from the crowd. I miss
we don't have too many events like that down here. Not at all.
No,
not like big city where they have usually like an event every other day. You know what I mean? Like in Austin, you'll see billboards. You know, Jay-Z was in one night, and then the following 2 days later, it was like. What are they called? Imagine Dragons came through all of a sudden. It's like, it was just 2 days of a difference. You know what I mean? Did they use the same stage or something? Like, who knows?
No, but, yeah, that arena, the Bird Dog Arena. Shout out to everybody on the staff, all the security, concessions, ticket punchers. That arena runs smoothly. Shout out to RGB Vipers and their staff and players and Coach Mahmood. That place is definitely allowing big names and big events to come out here, you know?
Shout out to Mr. Cantu. Shout out to Mr. Cantu. Over now, oh, Mr. Okay. Cantu. Plug for Mr. Cantu right there, for real. Cantu Construction.
So talk about your trip to Uruguay. How did that go? How was the food?
Dude, I had steaks and french fries every night. And I had a whole bottle of wine to myself every night. It was all paid
for. You a wine drinker? You like wine?
I never really tried as much wine as I did till I got there. It was kind of like, it was like the soda or the sweet tea. You know what I mean? Like when you go over there, you don't order a soda. You don't, they're like, would you like this? Would you like this? Or how about this? It pairs fine with your meats. And I was like, yeah, whatever. Whichever one. I really didn't know what to get. I don't know what to get. My first initial run-in with wine was at the first like group meeting party there in Uruguay. We had an official team group up. We finally got there in Uruguay. We got to the hotel. We got changed. We went to the arena. We met with our squad, with like the production crew, because I was part of the production crew. So I went to the production crew section, and. After that, I set up all my gear, made sure it worked for the next day, and then they're like, "All right, y'all can go." Anyways, we were able to go to this little like, wouldn't say it was an open bar, but it's basically what it was. It was an open.
Oh,
bar.
Oh yeah, yeah. Go ahead. All right, you're good.
It was an open bar, but so we went. they had like these trays with all these little mini foods. They're like, here, have a mini pizza, have a mini taco. And these were mini tacos. Like if it was like times five, it'd be a regular taco. But it was like a mini taco with like a strip of lettuce inside, a little slice of pepperoni and some beans. And like it was a little mini taco. So if you were just craving something, just tap it, swoosh it in.
But Miss April, the host of Vipers 360, is in the room. Cassie is also in the room. What's going on, Cassie? How you doing?
Hey, Cassie. DLG. Hills on Hardwood. Yes. Bring the heat.
Part of the media team for the Vipers. After the game, we go out and we interview the coaches, or the coach, Coach Mahmood, and the players. Man, I miss going to those games, man. And that's where we met. That's where we clicked. Saw you, I approached you and said, what's up? And I just want to thank you for being so cool, bro. For spreading the love. And I think we got 4 minutes left. So what's gonna happen then? What you know, we didn't really.
Oh, we never answered the. I'm bad. Yeah, yeah. I'm bad like
so
that.
Tell me.
I'm good.
Tell
I'm
me. Good at just no like, worries. I had a good time, bro. No worries. But DJ Villa, what's gonna happen for DJ Villa in the near future? And what's the end game for you? What's gonna be that checkpoint where you say to yourself, "Okay, I made it. I did. I accomplished something."
Never. There's never gonna be a checkpoint, bro. And I think I've learned this throughout my, at least right now, for the past 12 years of actually DJing, but 15 years of actually entertaining. I personally can't get enough of it. You know, it started in high school as like a little fucking like joke, but I ended up really enjoying it, you know? And I went home that day with the thought of, you know, I think I could be pretty good. I never thought I'd be, like, on point sometimes. And sometimes I feel like I am on point, you know. But other days, I'm not. Some days, I'm off. It's normal, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm in the groove some days, and some days, it's like, dude, put on this song. It's like, I'm sorry. Let me put it on. You know what I mean? But it's all in due time. But as far as for what you see or what I'm going to see, I see EDC again. I see Life is Beautiful soon. I see Colorado in the future. I see Las Vegas. Mm.
Hey, my sister's in Colorado.
I see Montevideo again. I see Brazil for sure. Argentina, mm-hmm. Chef Dante. Yo soy a chef.
You got yo. How do you pronounce that? Oh, never mind.
Yo soy a chef.
Yeah, I got it. And Wicked 88.
Wicked 88. Shout out to Eddie, my boy Eddie Spaghetti.
Hey, before we sign off, Villa, what do you think the world is going to look like? As far as humanity, I think like everybody's going to be a germaphobe after this. Nobody's going to want to hug and like kiss on the cheek type shit. And what do you think what do you think it's going to look like after this when we get back to normal? Do you think we'll get back to normal or what they're going to call normal from now on?
If we go back to normal, we're going to get another wave. If we at least take in consideration what new germs and what new scientists have learned, at least at this point, and just like anything, animals and humans, we all it's not called like develop or we mutate, like, you know. We learn to adapt. Everything's learning to adapt, whether it's a germ, even germs learn to adapt now. So things are going to get more crazy in the world. Aliens are real now. I'm going to say it on your fucking show. So
go ahead.
I'm just going to say it. I'm a firm believer. All y'all can think I'm crazy. I'm going to scroll up and down. All y'all can think I'm crazy, but it's whatever. My logo's an alien. I'm a firm believer. That's
really good
for me. You know what I'm saying?
Gustav,
shout out to ATX. What up, Gustav? Charlie, 9193. What up, brother?
Charlie, what's going on, Charlie? Just in time to be too late. Villa, thanks so much for joining me today. Have a great show at London's. Anybody in the Valley can catch DJ Villa at London's. And follow him at Villa for Real before I messed it up on that poster I made for the advertisement. Hey, Villa, take care of yourself. I'll hit you up, all right, bro?
Definitely. Don't forget, you can also follow me anywhere at therealdjvilla.com. That's therealdjvilla.com. Salud.
Peace.
Thanks, guys.